Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you'll learn how to get started with server-side tagging in Google Tag Manager. This is a new feature that Google has released. It lets you move tracking tags like Google Analytics from client-side to server-side. Okay, so what does that mean? Well, instead of the Google Analytics tag loading in the web browser for each visitor to your website, tags can run on your server. This means that Google Tag Manager server-side tagging can improve the performance of your website by reducing the number of JavaScript tags you use. And apart from improved performance, server-side tagging also gives you greater control over the data that is sent to the different analytics and advertising platforms you're using. Okay, it's time to get started. We need to create a new container in Google Tag Manager. I'm going to create a new container in my existing Google Tag Manager account. So I'm going to select the three vertical dots. And I'm going to select Create Container. Now we need to name our container. I'm going to call mine Loves Data Server-Side Demo. Then we need to select Server. And then we click Create. We're now prompted to set up our tagging server on Google App Engine. We can see there is an option to automatically provision our tagging server on App Engine, or we can set it up manually on App Engine. Let's leave the default option selected and click the Automatically Provision Tagging Server button. When we first set up our tagging server, we'll be using a single server, so this will be free. However, we will need to enter billing details in case we go over the free limits. For example, if you later decide to set up the recommended number of servers, which is 3 servers, then we will be charged. So let's click Create a Billing Account. We're taken to Google Cloud Platform and we need to enter our billing details. Now we're taken back to Google Tag Manager. We can check that our correct billing account is selected, and we can click the button to create our tagging server. One thing to flag is that if you're using G Suite, then you will need to make sure that Google Cloud Platform is enabled for your users in your G Suite account. If it's not enabled, then you'll see an error message. You will need to enable Cloud Platform before setting up the tagging server. Okay, this can take a little while, so let's skip ahead. We can now see the details for our tagging server. The main thing to highlight is the default URL. This is where we'll be sending our hits. You'll notice that it's currently an AppSpot domain, so this is the first thing we'll want to change. In order to take full advantage of server-side tagging, we need to configure this so that we're using our own domain. This lets us create first-party cookies for our website. To configure our own domain, let's start by heading to Google Cloud Platform. Let's select App Engine and then Settings. Now I'm going to select Custom Domains and then Add a Custom Domain. Now I'm going to select Verify a New Domain from the drop-down menu. This is because we want to configure our own subdomain to accept hits for our tagging server. I'm going to enter gtm.analyticsbeta.com and then I'm going to click Verify. Now I'm taken to Google Webmaster Central to verify that I own the domain. You can select your domain name provider from the list or scroll to the bottom and select Other. We need to add a TXT record to our domain's DNS, so let's copy the record. And I'm using Cloudflare to manage my DNS, so let's head to Cloudflare. The steps we're about to follow will be similar for other providers, but if you run into any problems, then I recommend contacting support for your domain name provider. In Cloudflare, I've already selected my domain, and then I've selected DNS. Now I'm going to create a new record by clicking Add Record. Let's select TXT as the record type. Enter GTM as the name, and then paste the value we copied from Webmaster Central. Now I'm going to click Save. And we can see the record has been added. Now let's head back to Webmaster Central. I can now click Verify. We can see that our subdomain has been verified, and we can now head back to Google Cloud Platform. Let's click Refresh. And we can again see we've verified the subdomain. And let's click Continue. I'm going to remove the www version of the domain. And let's click Save Mappings. Let's click Continue. And now we need to add some more DNS records for our subdomain, so we'll need to copy these. And now let's head back to Cloudflare. I'm going to add a new record. I need to make sure it's an A record. Enter my subdomain, and then enter the IP address provided by Google. I'm also going to click Proxied so that it becomes DNS only. Now I'm going to click Save. And repeat this for the other records. And then for the AAAA records. Now we can head back to Google Cloud Platform and click Done. A SSL certificate will now be created for our subdomain. This can take a while, so let's skip ahead. Now let's head back to Google Tag Manager. We need to update Google Tag Manager with our custom subdomain, so let's select Admin. And then Container Settings. Now we can update our tagging server URL. Let's change this to our subdomain. And click Save. Now let's head back to the workspace. And let's select Clients. This is the main difference you'll notice between web containers and server-side containers. A client in a server-side container listens for incoming data and makes that data available to use in our tags. We can see there are two default clients. There is a client for data coming from a Universal Analytics tag and a client for data coming from an app and web property tag. In this video, we're going to use data coming from an existing Universal Analytics tag. Let's select this client. There are different changes you can make to the client. These include changing the priority for the client. Basically, if you have multiple clients listening for the same type of incoming data, then you can control which client will accept the data first. We're going to leave this set to the default. The other option I want to highlight is the activation criteria. As I mentioned, I'm going to use an existing Universal Analytics tag in a Google Tag Manager web container to send data to our server-side container. However, if you've implemented the Google Analytics tracking code directly on your site, then you might need to modify the activation criteria. For example, if you're using the gtag.js version of the tracking code on your site, then you'd need to select this option. Okay, let's close the client. We're going to configure the server-side container to pass a hit through to Universal Analytics and to also send data to an app and web property. So let's select Tags. And create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics Universal Analytics. And let's select Tag Configuration. We can see there are only three built-in tags currently available for our server-side container. These are Google Analytics tags for app and web properties, for Universal Analytics, and there is a HTTP request tag. Let's select Universal Analytics. Since I'm going to be using a Universal Analytics tag to send data to this tag, it means data will simply pass through this tag and we can leave all of the default settings. However, we could modify the data before it is sent to Google Analytics. For example, we could change the property ID if we wanted the data to be sent to a different Google Analytics property, or if we wanted data to be sent to multiple Google Analytics properties. Now, let's select Triggering. And let's select the blue plus sign to create a new trigger. Let's name our trigger Universal Analytics All Events. All triggers in server-side containers are custom, so we can leave this selection. And we can then see that by default the trigger will fire on all events. This means that it will look for any event created by any of our clients and trigger our tag. Since we saw there was a Universal Analytics client and an app and web client, we're going to change this, since we only want to trigger our tag for Universal Analytics events. So let's select Some Events. And let's select Choose Built-in Variable from the dropdown. Now let's select Client Name. Then equals. And enter Universal Analytics. This will mean our tag only fires when a Universal Analytics event occurs. Now let's click Save. And let's save our tag. So far we've created a single tag, so this means that we're simply passing data through our server-side container. At the moment, it wouldn't reduce the code that we load on our website. So let's add another tag. We're going to use the same event, or inbound data from Universal Analytics, to fire a second tag in our server-side container. Let's add another tag. Let's name this tag Google Analytics App and Web. Let's select Tag Configuration. And let's select the App and Web tag. Since the inbound data will be for Universal Analytics, and I want the data to go directly to my app and web property, I'm going to add the measurement ID from my app and web property. Now I'm going to select Page View as the event name. Let's select Triggering. Since our existing implementation might be sending more than just page views to Google Analytics, I'm going to create a new trigger to only fire the tag when page view data is coming through to our client. So let's click the blue plus sign to create a new trigger. Let's name the trigger Universal Analytics Page View Events. And let's change the firing rule to Some Events. Let's select Client Name, equals, and enter Universal Analytics. And now let's click the plus sign. Let's select Choose Inbuilt Variable, and let's select Query String. This will let us match values that are included in the hit. Let's leave Contains, and then enter T equals Page View. This will mean that the trigger only fires the tag for page view hits. Now let's save the trigger. And let's save the tag. We will now be using our server-side container to listen for Universal Analytics data and then use this to send data to both a Universal Analytics property and an app and web property in Google Analytics. Let's click Preview. A new tab opens to preview our tags for our server-side container. One thing I want to highlight is that you need to ensure you're using a single browser window to preview your tags and your website. You can't debug your tags in separate browser windows. We'll come back to check our tags in a moment. The next thing we need to do is modify our Google Tag Manager web container to send data to our new server-side container, instead of directly to Google Analytics. So let's head to our web container. We can see our web container has two tags, one for Universal Analytics and another for App and Web Properties. So we're going to start by modifying our Universal Analytics tag. To do this, I'm going to select Variables. And then Google Analytics. This is the Google Analytics settings variable used by my Universal Analytics tag. Let's select the variable. And let's select Advanced Configuration. We now need to enter the URL we configured for our server-side container as the transport URL. So I'm going to enter https://gtm.analyticsbeta.com. Now I'm going to save the tag. Next, I'm going to select Tags. And I'm going to pause the App and Web tag. This is because we have replicated this tag in our server-side container, so we no longer need to add this tag using our web container. So let's pause the tag. Now let's preview the changes. I'm using demo accounts for this walkthrough, so if you're making changes to your production or live website, then you will need to ensure you upgrade your project in Google Cloud Platform first. You'll also want to test your implementation. One way to do this is to create new Google Analytics properties and use these when testing your server-side container. Since all of my accounts are demo accounts, I'm happy to make these changes. I'm going to head to my demo site. And I'm going to reload the page to open the Google Tag Manager Debug Console. We can see that only a single tag is fired on the page. It's our Universal Analytics tag. Now let's head back to the Preview tab for our server-side container. We can now see that the incoming request has been captured by our server-side container, and we can see that this has resulted in two tags being triggered. We can see both our Universal Analytics tag and our App and Web tag has been triggered. We'll now be able to see data in our Google Analytics reports. That's it. So that's how you can get up and running with server-side tagging in Google Tag Manager. Since this is a new feature in Google Tag Manager, we are currently limited to a small number of built-in tags. There are currently tags for Google Analytics, including Universal Analytics and App and Web Properties. And there is also a HTTP request tag. This means that if you currently want to use server-side tagging for other platforms, like Facebook, you will have to make your own tag template. Otherwise, it's a case of waiting until more built-in tags become available. This means it's a good time to start learning about Google Tag Manager server-side tagging, so you're ready when new tags are added and more features are released. Are you going to start experimenting with server-side tagging? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please subscribe, share it with your friends, and hit the like button so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.